Okay, students, in the previous class also, last class also, we discussed about how to create a table, how to insert the record into the table, that the topic regarding that we discussed. Okay, then moreover, how to select all the records from the table, how to select, that is how to view only the desired or needed columns only, how to see by using the second command. You can see that select column name, that is field name, from table name. By using the query, we can able to see the required column alone. Okay, then how to change the order of the column in our in the viewpoint. Okay, for example, which one want to be at first in our view, like that all we have discussed. Okay, and let me go to the next things. Okay, distinct keyword we used. What is the use of distinct keyword? Can anyone can say that?
Sir, it will avoid all the duplicates.
Duplicates. So it will only gives the. Only the unique values which is in the column. Okay, that is the use of unique keyword. By using the unique keyword, we can get the it will avoid the duplicates value, but it will display all the values. There is unique value. Okay, that is the concept. And next thing is
simple. So now, sir, okay.
Yes.
So name matto same. So name matto different. The salary matto same anchna. How it be, sir?
See, first of all, try to understand distinct keyword, which column we are applying, that column alone it will display. For example, salary, all the salary are same. If you are using the distinct keyword on the column, which column means that column key, values alone it will display. Have you understand?
Oh, okay, sir.
For example, salary columns is there, no? Salary column, we are giving 10,000 two members. Okay, 20,000 for four members. If you are asked to using the distinct keyword, if you are using mean 10,000, 20,000, two values only it will show. Repeated value it won't show. Okay, it is not for the entire table; it's for the specific column. Okay, and okay, we have discussed already. Yeah, the performing a simple calculation by using the dummy tables. That is already the DBMS provide or creates the dummy table. That name of the table is called dual table. Okay, that we have seen. Things also, you can see dual is here table. It is a dummy table which is created by the DBMS. That is a MySQL itself, it will create that one. Okay, and moreover, current date function will tells the, or it will print the or display the current date which is in our system. Okay, so that date it will display it. Okay, simply if you are giving without using the table these things. Okay, select current date. Simply if we give means are from dual. If you are giving means automatically the date will be it will be printed or it will be displayed in the table. Okay, and we have seen how to multiply the salaries, all those things and all we have discussed. Okay, with the table and how to give the alias name for the column in the view. Okay, view of viewing of the table, how to change the column name. So that we discussed. For example, salary into 12 we do on calculation. So what is the resultant column will be? The resultant field will be. Should be named as annual income means that also we can do it. Okay, these things we can we discussed in the last class. Okay, and handling null, any value if it is null means how to handle with that or how to assign with instead of null how to assign another name or another message in the null place. Okay, so that also we discussed. Do you have any doubt in this concept? So far we discussed and last
no,
thing.
No sir.
Yeah, and rupees. No, for example, if you want to insert any. Text or any percentage symbol or any symbols if you want to add before or after the text means that also we can do but the concat function that is a very important thing concatenation okay string concatenation we discussed in Python here concat is one of the functions string function it is used to merge the two strings okay even though you are given a number but we should given a single quote no single or double quote no so that it will take as a character only merging the two character that is one character and plus one column name that is very important salary is a column name there is a field okay so the field may be integer or character that is not a matter it will add the append means not at the last it will add the given values the given symbol or string with the prefix or postfix that is a before the value or after the value that is salary okay for example rupees rs dot salary 10,000 we can print rs 10,000 then space rupees rupees likewise we can print also okay that is another method okay, today we are entering into the one of the important thing, wear class. Okay, so wear class is a very basic and very necessary class for the all SQL operation. Okay, without this wear class, we cannot perform much in the SQL. That is very important. Okay, because the wear class only providing how to select. That is, we discussed one thing. No, can you do? Can you remember the two type of DML language we have seen? Procedural DML, non-procedural DML. I said a very short word. Can you recall that two type of DML languages are there? What is DML? Full form for DML is what?
Data manipulation
language.
That time I said there are two type of, in the slide also it was mentioned for the previous videos. That is a procedural DML, non-procedural DML. Two type of data manipulation languages are there. Okay, what is the difference, sir? What is the why it is classified? If you are saying means procedural DML, it will tell what to select and how to select. That is how what to select the data, what data to be selected, and how to select the data or how to retrieve the data. Select means in the sense of retrieving or getting the data. Okay, that is, if you are telling the two things, means that is procedural. Non-procedural means what data we need. Okay, what the data we need to select, that only. It won't tell how to select the data. That is non-procedural DML. Okay, that is the difference. That what I said, that whenever we are going to the next topics, you can automatically understand. That is for where class only we are using. The where class tells how to select the data. Okay, what to select we know. For example, select name from EMP. That is means what? The query for example, I am writing select name from EMP. EMP is a table means. What's the meaning?
They written all the where.
All the names. Yeah, all the names. Name is a column name. No. So all the, it is a field. Yes, so in the field, whatever all the names are there, it will display it. Okay. It is a what to select. That only it will tell. That is called non-procedural. Okay. How to select? For example, select all the name. Who is getting the salary greater than 10,000 if you are giving another details. Okay. So that is called what? How to select, or which need to select, which to select. Okay. By using how to segregate the data, or how to filter the data, or how to customize the viewing point. That is the data want to be shown to the user by using the where class. Okay. This is very important in the SQL. Okay. You can see. Where that is where class is used to specific select specific rows. It allows to select only the desired row by applying the condition. Okay, by giving the condition, we can select the row. Okay, for example, the name should start with the alphabet A. That name only display. Or else the salary who is getting this much range, that is between the 10,000 and 15,000. Okay, that name list alone I need. That is also possible. Who is working in a specific department? That department people alone I want to discuss. That is, I like to display in the screen. That is also possible. Okay, by based on the condition, we can do it. Okay, here we can use all the comparison. First one, you know that. What is the first symbol? The selecting one, you just tell the symbols.
Greater than.
This is less than. This is. Greater than or equal to.
Okay. Greater than or equal to. Less than or equal to. Equal to.
Last one is called not equal to. Okay, this is the different one. In Python, how we use not equal to symbol? Exclamatory symbol and equal to symbol. We use it, no? That is in Python. But here, the not equal to will be what? It is in different case. Greater than, sorry, less than greater than symbol. If you are using together, means that is not equal to. Okay, these are all the comparison operator. Here we have seen the relationship operator, relation operator in Python. The first unit, first chapter we discussed, isn't it? There is relation operator, but here it is called as comparison operator. And logical operator, what are the logical operators? Three operators are there. You know that AND, OR, NOT. Okay. For example, NOT here, the exclamatory symbol. OR means the two bars, where it is means in the keyboard you can see slash is there, no backward slash. In the key it is there, okay. The bar, that is called R. And symbol means ampersand symbol. You know that. Okay. So we have to use this symbol, or we have to use the word AND, OR, R or NOT. Okay. You know that what is the use of AND. AND means it will check the both the conditions to be true. R means any one of the condition is true means that is okay. NOT means what? Not equal to, not in this list. okay, apart from that, not in membership operator we discussed, no? Can you recall that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Likewise here, in not in means, likewise here, in not in not there. Only not operator. That is not a logical operator. Okay, not equal to, not greater than, not less than. Okay, that is the concept. Okay, let me see some example. Afterwards, we will also do our own thing. Okay, you can see, select all from EMP. EMP is what? What is EMP?
Employee table.
Table name. Good. Okay. This is a table name where salary greater than 4,000. So, what the data will be displayed? This select, this query. This is called query. Okay. The first query display all the columns or all the fields. But what is the thing? Whose salary is greater than 4,000? That details alone, it will display. That the records alone, it will display. Have you understand? And next thing,
yes,
select, yeah, select all from EMP. Second query I'm saying. Okay. Select all from EMP where employee number, EMP number equal to 1. Okay, equal to means not here, double equal to, single equal to only. Okay, that is also one notable change in the Python, then the Python to SQL. Okay, so you can see employee equal to 1. Employee number equal to 1 means what? It only display the particular number only, particular record only. It will display only one record. Whose employee number is number 1. Okay. And you can see select name department from EMP where department equal to HR. So what the third query will display? Can you see?
It will show the name also, sir.
It will show the name, then department also, no?
Department.
Yeah, name, yes, department. But which department it only show?
HR.
Yeah, who is belong to HR department, that details alone it will show. For example, for our in office, somebody is asking, who are all the HR people, who is working under the HR wing, I want to see all the details. Means
sir, HR, sir.
Human resources, one of the department in every company or office. Okay, who is that is a person who is doing the work for procurement or recruitment, okay. All the purchasing will be done by the HR. Okay. And HR is a likewise admin for your understanding. In admin office is there, no? In school.
Yes, sir.
Likewise HR. In company, we should say it is a HR. Okay. Okay, let me see that. So it only display all the things who is belong to the department. Okay, that detail alone, that name and the department alone, it will display. Rest of the things, it won't display. So it is, this WHERE class is very much useful. That's what I am repeatedly I am saying, that it is very much useful to segregate the data and performing the operations on over the specific data. Okay, upcoming slide you can see that how to update the data where this condition is. For example, one company is there, more than 10,000 workers are working there. Okay, so just the boss is, the owner is like to give salary increment. Okay. So just I want to know the detail, who are all getting less than 5,000 rupees, add 1,000 rupees for them. So if he will say just only one word to the office people, that is for your understanding, to the HR people. Okay, if we are maintaining the SQL means, that is if you are maintaining the database means. Okay, it is very simple. What is the query? Can anyone say? For example, I will tell, have you understand this, my question?
So once more, sir.
Yeah, I will tell again. For example, a company is there. Okay, a company, 1,000 members for our limitation. Okay, 100 members are working. Let you take it. 100 members, employee are working in a company. Okay, the boss is coming in and he's given an order. Who are all getting less than 5,000 rupees salary, add 1,000 rupees to them, to their salary. That is, for example, anybody getting 4,000, less than 5,000, I'm saying, not equal to 5,000. Okay, for example, less than or equal to 5,000, those who are anybody getting means, add the 1,000 rupees to them. Likewise, the given the instruction. Okay, how will you make that?
Select salary plus 1,000 from EMP, where salary is less than 5,000.
Less than or equal to 5,000. Super, 5, nicely you said. Very nice, I really appreciate you, Silveram. Have you understand the rest of the students?
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good. Krishna Prasad, what about you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So that is what we, that's what I'm saying. No, whatever the operation, for example, if we didn't use the database, means what we have to do? We have to find manually who are all selected, who are all getting the salary. For example, less than 5,000. Even though if we are using the Excel, okay, of course we can do it. I'm not saying that, but even though if we are using in the Excel software, means we need to find, even though we are applying filter, we need to select all the ranges. Somebody may get 2,000, someone may get 2,500. Okay, likewise, it is a huge number of lists. If it is 100 members, we can do it. If it is 1,000 members, means it is impossible. No, that is, human error will happen. That's what. Okay, even though it is, for example, 25,000, it is there, 2,500 is there. By looking the data, what will happen? Definitely, for our eyes, 2,500 and 25,000 looking similar. 10 only, na? Have you understand my question? So that's what human error is there. Okay, it will occur. Okay, it is not an easy thing, no. So 25,000 is bigger amount. Simply, if you add one more 1,000 for them, means it will create a chaos between the. For example, those who are getting 25,000 also, 1,000 rupees hike will be given. Likewise, they may think. Okay, so for that only, for not only this one, likewise, a many important thing by we can easily do with the wear condition. As Selvaram said, just one line we can do it. We no need to write a query, or we no need to We no need to write a paragraph of line by lines of quotes and all. Not necessary. Just one line, just one query. Okay, that's what the SQL provide, that much of facility to that to maintain the database. Now you can understand. Okay, what is the importance of database? Once the data, for example, if you are storing the 10 members or 20 members details, means you won't find that much of effectiveness of the RDBMS. Suppose if you are going there more than 50 members data, if you are storing, okay, all the details you stored more than 50, definitely you will feel the importance of the RDBMS. That's what all the fields, education field or medical field, transport, factories, industries, whatever thing, they are maintaining the SQL. They are maintaining the database, I'm saying. Okay. So this is very important. That's what we will come to know. So the WHERE class is very much important to do whatever operation, n number of operation based on the condition. That is very important. Okay. With the given condition, comparison operator and logical operator, with that we can do n number of operations. Okay. You can see the example. And not. And or not, how to use. Likewise, you can see this example. Select, first query I'm reading. Okay. Select all from EMP where salary greater than 4,000 and salary less than 8,000. So what it will do? The first query is. I'm selecting, no? What is it?
It will show the employee from 4,000 to 8,000.
Yeah, who is getting? Greater than 4,000, not equal to 4,000. Those who are getting 4,000 and above, and less than 8,000, not 8,000, 7,799. Likewise, so till the data, it will display it. Very good. We can segregate it, okay, by the salary. You can see second query, select from EMP where department equal to sales and salary less than 30,000. So it only display the names, that is not only name, all the records, who is belong to the, you can see the condition, where department equal to sales. So sales department person name list and all it will display. And moreover, one more segregation we made, one more filter we made, that is what, who is getting less than 30,000. Okay, the sales department, somebody's 5 members can get less than 30,000, 3 members may get greater than 30,000. So it only displays the certain 5 members only. Okay. So you can see this. These are all examples. Okay. For that, you can get an idea how to use the WHERE condition. That is WHERE class. Okay. In which way and all we can use it. And AND operator, how they are effectively using the AND operator. Like this, you can get an idea. You can see this. One more AND operator. Select name department from EMP where department equal to HR and the salary. What is the thing? Greater than or equal to 20,000 and salary less than or equal to 40,000. So it will display from 20,000 equal to, no. So from 20,000 to 40,000, it will display, isn't it? From HR department only.
Yes.
Okay. It will display the name and their department. That is department as HR only. Okay. So likewise, we can use it by seeing that it will be easy, but we have to apply in our table wherever business required. For example, if we are using the student database, just think it how to use in your project. Okay, so that is a very important. Okay, for example, if you are doing any project, means you can use this. Rajchagar, how about your project? Are you doing? First, I have doubt whether are you listening the class. Hello. I think he is doing some other work. You people are doing like that. I have very strong doubt.
No sir.
Okay.
But no sir.
No sir. No sir.
Okay. Okay, children. Very good. Okay. Let you see the next command by using R. Okay. Select all from, that is star means we should pronounce as all, A-L-L, okay. Select all from EMP, all means all the fields, from EMP means EMP table, okay. Where department equal to HR, or department equal to IT, what is the meaning? What is the display, what did display?
Sir, it will display the employees from the table. If they are in HR department or they are in IT department, if so anyone satisfied, it will display.
Sir. Correct. So it will display there both the peoples. I mean, the people who is working in HR department as well as IT department. So how the question will be asked in board exam? No. So the question will be asked, write a query to, they will give on table. For example, employee ID, employee name, department. Okay. Three columns are there. In the department, many departments are there. For example, as you see in IT, HR, sales, marketing, likewise, they will give a number of, for example, 10 details they will give. Okay, 10 records they will give. Okay, they will ask the question, display only the person name, that is, display only the employee ID, who belongs to HR department and the IT department. They will give by making you confused. And IT department, they will use the word. By seeing that, shall we use the and operator here? No, not possible. What is the query? I will repeat it. Write a query in MySQL to display the employee ID from the table employee who belongs to the HR department and the IT department.
Select EMP ID from EMP where department is equal to HR or department is equal to IT.
Very nice. Now we understand. No, so here they are selecting all the records, I mean all the fields. Now we want to only specify the specific field. We want to display the specific field means we have to use like that. Okay. So that is very important. So this type of questions only they will ask. Okay. There's 1 mark or 2 marks. Such type of questions will be asked in the MySQL part. Okay. So you have to well word. That's what I'm taking this much of time to explain you. This is a very basic concept. Maximum questions will be, you will be anymore. For example, we will very, it is twisted questions and all will be asked from this where class. Okay. So they will ask very tricky, very twisting manner, but we should not get confused. Not what I'm saying. That is not an example. You can see the real example also. If you want to read 2 or 3 times. Then understand the meaning. Then only you have to write. This is all. I'm always saying that, especially in the query, we have to think two or three times. Okay. Let you see the last query. You can see. Select all from EMP where not employee number equal to 4. That means what it will display. The last query. Select all from EMP.
If the employee number is not 4. It will display there. If it is 4, it will not display.
Very good. Not employee number equal to 4 means except the number 4, employee number 4, all the details it will display except the number 4. Okay, very good. So it will check one by one. Okay, these are all the things in the where class. Apart from that, you can see between. Between is one of the keyword in. Okay, whether it is present in there or not. Like. Similar searching. If you want to search a similar type of data, let me use the like. Is null. If it is any null value is there. For example, in a factory or in a company, newly joined people, they didn't fix the salary. Okay. So negotiation is happening. So the database administrator can provide the details. Whose salary and all, it's mentioned as null. they given an appointment order, but of course appointment order itself they will mention the salary. Anyhow, for example, the fixation is not completed means whose detail is null. Somebody, they may not give their email ID, for example. So you want to segregate that who are all not given their email ID. So let that, if you want to sort out that details alone by using the is null. Okay, let me see one by one. So these are all the operators we are using in our SQL. Okay, let me go to the next one. I mean, you can see this between. Between means it will set the range. Okay, between this number and that number. You can see the query. Select all from EMP where these and all, everything will use the where class. Where class is a basic, that's what I'm repeatedly I'm saying. It's a basic command in the SQL. Okay, without that, we cannot do much more operations. We can do other than little bit operation, but this is a very important command, very important class. Okay, where salary between, salary is what? Can you say what is salary? Hello.
Department.
Department.
Field name, sir.
Field name. EMP is what?
Field name.
EMP is what?
Table name.
Table name.
Okay. So now you can understand. Now select all the fields from the table EMP where salary between 18,000 and 30,000. That means what? What it will display? Using the keyword between. Let I will tell that. The salary who is getting 18,000, 18,000 1 rupee, 18,000 something, this goes to 20,000. Likewise, it goes up to 30,000. Suppose 30,000 1 rupee is there, means it won't display that one. Okay, not greater than.
So,
yeah, of course, same thing. Between the two ranges. Okay, so it will display the, here, what is the thing? It will display all the records. Okay, suppose you want to know only the name, means select name from EMP. Likewise, we can give the comment. Of course, second thing is there, you can see. Select name from EMP where employee number between 2 and 5. So that details alone, it will display. Okay, for example, if anybody want to, a new team has to form for the new methodology, that is new technology somebody want to learn. Okay, so who can be allotted? Because who is the younger person, they may be allotted, no? Have you understand? For example, to learn the new one, new technology. The older people, that is, they will struggle a little bit to understand the new technology, isn't it? For example, for that, you want to segregate between the, by using the date of birth. So how we can give it? For example, date of year is mentioned, or else date of birth is mentioned, means you can see select name from EMP, where DOB, suppose the field name is date of birth means, okay, the DOB between, we can give the name, for example, 31-12-2020, likewise. We can give the year, that's what I'm saying, okay. So between the year, who are all, whose date of birth is, for example, I'm saying, okay. So whose date of birth, whose birth on that, between the limit means that name list alone, that employee worker list alone, it will display. Okay, for whatever purpose I'm saying. So this is the way we are using the between. This is one of the important keyword. There is one of the important operator. Okay, so between. Have you understand how to use the between operator?
Yes, sir. Yes. Understood, yeah, fine, sir.
Fine. You can see. You can see the third query. Select all from EMP where salary not between 25,000 and 35,000. That means what? I will read it again. You can understand that. Select all the fields, all the record from EMP, from the table where salary not between 25,000 and 35,000. That means what will display? Suppose I will tell that, okay, Kumar, one person, he is getting 24,000. Whether his name will be displayed or not? For example, one person is getting 24,000 in the table EMP. Okay. Whether his name is display this query will display or not? Hello,
display.
I didn't get it, Chaluram. Yeah.
It will display it, sir.
it will display, because the question is, I mean, the condition is how we are given, not between. It's not asking between, not between. So those who are getting 25,000 to 35,000, that is between the 25,000 and 35,000, their name, their records alone not display. It won't display the salary who is getting 25,000 to, that is 25,000 and 35,000. Okay. Their details, this query will not display. Rest of the query, suppose any one person is getting 1,000 rupees, one person is getting 1 lakh rupee, whatever thing. So it will display rest of the all the records, that is rest of the details from the table. Okay. Have you understand how to use the not here? You can use where class we are using.
Yeah,
I know that. You can see, select all, it will display who is getting the, it won't display, I'm so sorry, it won't display, the third query will not display who are all getting the salary, 25,000 and 35,000. Rest of the things, rest of the person's details alone, it will display. Have you understood, Chandru?
Yes, sir, understood, sir.
Yeah. Very nice. Okay, let me go to the in operator. In, it is checking to, I already said that. The in operator, likewise, how we are using membership operator, we used, no? In, not in. Hello? We used, no?
Yes, sir.
Here also, in, not yes, in is there, but here we should not say it is a membership operator. It is one of the, in is one operator, not is another operator. Okay, we can combine the two things. Nothing wrong with in, not in. By seeing that it is a single operator, if it is asking, means don't get confused. There is no membership operator in SQL. Okay. But it is in Python. Don't get confused. Here, you can see select all from EMP where department in sales and IT. Sales, IT. That means what it will display. The first query. What it will display? It will select all the record. Who are all belongs to the department sales and IT. Okay. So for example, it will display the records of the all the people who is belong to the sales department and who is working, that is belongs to the IT department. So all the records, all the people, that is employer records, are the name will be name, as well as all the records will be displayed. Okay. So in means it will check the, it will first, it will take one record. How it is executing? No. So first it will take one record and check its department, whether the department is in sale. Suppose no. Okay. Then suppose the department is in IT. Yes, of course. Then it will do it. Okay. 1 minute only, children. Then again, rejoin it immediately. Okay. For example, you may think that, sir, why can't we use and operator, sir? You can ask the question also, where department equal to sales or, okay, we can use the or operator, not and operator, or operator. And where department equal to IT. If it is two department, means, okay, suppose a company having 20 departments. Okay, from the 20 department, we need to select from the 10 departments. We can write a very lengthy query, no? Where department equal to sales or where department equal to IT. Likewise, or likewise, we have to write a very lengthy command. Okay, instead of that, we can create a list. List means not our Python list. Just here, I'm saying that we can create a list. List means in the bracket. We can pass as argument. Okay. Sales and IT, likewise, HR department, CSE department, mechanical, likewise. Okay, you can.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So, as we discussed in the last, and you can see, select all from EMP where department in sales. This is the uniqueness of the in operator. In operator, we can select, for example, who are all getting, who are all belongs, for example, city, who are all coming from Chennai. One organization is there, okay, multiple persons, a number of employees are working on the factory or any other company from different location. Somebody's come from Chennai, somebody from Coimbatore, from Lucknow, from Delhi, likewise Bangalore, likewise many people working from different locations. So if you want to segregate, okay, who are all belongs to this particular cities. For example, I want to get the details of the person who is coming from the Chennai, Bangalore, and Delhi or Hyderabad. Okay. Then we can give the four names, Chennai, comma, in the single quote or double quote. Okay. Because it is a string, no. So we should give in this thing, Chennai, comma, Bangalore, comma, Hyderabad. Likewise, if we give means, it only displays that details alone. the employee details alone. Okay, so that is very important. For example, some movies and all, you may see that I will take that record, who is working, that within a minute they will taking know. For example, any police inquiry, likewise if it is, have you seen such type of movies? They will search everything in the computer and they are getting the details, who are all getting like this. But it is very dramatically it will shows. Okay, likewise a printing statement, green color or blue color screen, that is not okay. Really, we can make like that. Okay, some things we can easily segregate the data if you are maintaining the database means. That is very, that's what I'm coming to tell. Okay, in operator, it will plays a very important role. Okay, and not in means not from the city. Except the cities, I want to know all the persons. If it is means, we can give that what? That city name again. For example, I don't like to a person come from Bangalore. Except that Bangalore, I want to know the rest of the people means. Then not in Bangalore, we should give. Okay, then rest of the all the records will be displayed. I mean, who are all come from that place? Have you understand my example? Hello.
Yes, sir. Understood.
So that's that's what. So that is a important of in and not in. Here not is one operator. What is not operator? I mean.
So these are two cover ellame.
No, I'm not asking in the sense. Try to understand. Not is which type of operator? For example, relation operator. We have discussed. No. Let I will tell. Not
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Logical operator.
Logical operator, sir. Operator.
Okay. So in that, what I am coming to tell, not is different operator, I mean separate operator, in is another operator. We are using two operator together. Okay, somebody is coming in chat, but chat is not opening for me. If you are seeing something is better, because I am trying to open the chat box, it is not get opening. Okay, sometimes I cannot reply for that also because it is not opening. You don't think that I am giving a chat box, sir, doesn't listen. I just clicked that, but it is not opening. What to do? Okay, children, let me see this. So this is the important of in and not. That is in operator, how to use with the combination of not. That is a logical operator. Okay, so these are all the things. And like, this is very important thing. Okay, so in the like, many specifications are there, many types are there. Let me see one by one. Okay, like operator, let me explain what is the use means. It is used to, for example, we know, but we don't know the proper things. Okay, somebody some name, for example, you know one person name, his name is start with the letter S, but you forgot the name, whether he is a Saravanan or whatever name. Okay, tell some name. Satish. Okay, or Selvaram or Sabeshan, likewise Sundaresh or likewise whatever name. So we forgot his name, so I want to know whose names which start with the letter S. Okay, with that at all, we can like. By using the operator, like operator, we can search the data type. That is, we can display the data type. Okay, you can see. Let me see this one thing. Like allow, there is a like operator, allow to search based on pattern. Okay, not only the letter, pattern also. For example, star or whatever thing we can give. It is used to when we don't know, there is a don't want to search the exact value. Exact value means we forgot the exact value, or you can see this. We don't know the exact value, but we only know the pattern. Pattern means here the first letter, definitely his letter will be, sometimes no, his name is start with the S, but I forgot his name. Likewise, we may have no. So that the type of things. Okay, so we can use this like operator. You can see first one is percentage, used to when we want to substitute multiple characters with the percentage. Okay, I will show the example, you can understand better. For example, search a employee whose name begins with S. Okay, so for example, you have a database, thousands of members are there. Okay, you want only, yeah, yes, yes, Chandru, you say something,
sir. Voice konna thodi break aanuchu, sir.
Okay, now is it okay?
Is it yes, okay? Sir, now okay.
Okay. That is like operator. I will repeat it. Like operator, you use it to search a related. We don't know the exact value, but we know the approximate value. Which is that approximate letters or characters? With that, we can search. Let me see the example means you can understand. Search for employee. First query is okay. That is the first question is search for employee whose name begins with S. So some names you want to know the name who are all whose names and all started with S means you can see. Select all from EMP, that is table, where name like, there's the operator, like is one of the operator, like yes percentage. Yes percentage means what? Start with, okay, who's, for example, which one? Start with yes means the yes want to specify the first one, then percentage. Okay, and for example, somebody's name end with another
sir,
name.
Percentage na nareya per kadka solranga
sir. No, not like that. It is a not like that. Don't think that. It is a default method.
The syntax, no sir.
Yeah, of course, syntax. Okay, it is a syntax to search your data. Okay, percentage is a for example, it is like as a specific access specifier. Okay, if you want to access certain type of data, for example, whose name is start with yes means. Here, what is the notable changes means? You try to understand. Yes, we should mention previously. Then only it will display whose name begins. Begins means start with the letter yes. Okay, that is the thing. And something search for employee whose name end with. You can see that. 1 minute. Come. Sriraman, sir, can you tell again, sir, percentage? I will tell again. See, the percentage is not anything. Okay, it is one of the additional character or syntax to search in the like is operator actually. Sriram, just try to understand. Like is operator. With that operator, what is the use of the operator means? To search a similar value. Okay, suppose you want to know whose names and all start with yes means. Okay, then how to search in the record? How to search in the table means? Select all from EMP, that is table name, where name like in the single quote, yes percentage. Okay, yes percentage, semicolon, as you know, every statement want ends with semicolon. Okay, so yes percentage means it will display whose names and all start with yes. Okay, suppose second query, you can see whose name ends with R. Okay, Satish Kumar, okay, Magesh Kumar, R, if ends with R. So such details we want to display means, you can see the notable changes within the single quote or double quote. Percentage R, not R percentage, percentage R. Okay, before you can see yes percentage, that means starting letter with
starting.
Yes, then some other Satish or Saravanan or as you said,
Selvaraman.
Yeah, Selvaram, we can give whatever name. Okay, but here, second thing is you just note down percentage R. So the name may be start with whatever, Naveen Kumar or Satish Kumar or, okay, the name start with whatever letter, not an issue, but whose names and all ends with the letter R. Sorry, ends with the, of course, character R. Have you understand the difference between?
The yes, two? Sir.
Yeah, this is one of the important thing.
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Yes. So just to try
sir,
to.
Sir, Rajasekhar varu, sir.
Rajasekhar. Okay. He is asking Sriraman, sir, for starting the syntax is, of course, starting. If you want to search a name with the starting means, not yes percentage is fixed. For example, somebody's name, who are all names start with A, then A percentage. Okay, the letter is not, is yes is not fixed one. The name which we need to start, we can give one to the name start with A or some other things. Okay, that is the thing. Yes, he is asking in the chat. Okay, Sriraman. Okay, for example, whose name is end with R? Okay, it's not is R is the constant one. Instead of that, we can give whatever thing also. Okay, middle it is not possible for. He is asking for middle name. If you want to find means, it is not possible. If you store the record, first name, last name, middle name, like with a three field means, it is possible. Okay, in the single thing, if you want to search means, it's not possible. Of course, middle is another one. I will tell it differently. Okay, it is not suitable for, you can see anywhere means not in middle. Third thing, next thing is anywhere A. It may be a first also, it may be a last also, in middle also, it is only particularly selecting with middle, it is not possible. Okay, students, I hope you understand the like operator, how to use in the starting and beginning. Okay, that tomorrow we will see the example.
Yes, also.
And afterward, we will go for the remaining like operators. That is the remaining functions also. Okay, nice time with you.
Okay,
see you all. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Have a good day, sir.
Have a